I'm one of the founders of EduWatch, a vernacular K-12 predictive infotainment-based learning platform for the bottom-of-pyramid customers. We were founded in July 2017 and currently one of the top edtech platforms in India. We're on a mission here to deliver equitable education to every last Indian. So first is augmented learning. AR-based apps, that is augmented reality-based apps, will provide true immersive learning experience. Second is virtual reality, which will actually gamify the entire education sector. And third is the use of data science and big data, like machine learning and artificial intelligence, which will enable us to predict a student's learning curve. That is, for example, his strengths and weaknesses. It will provide a surgical precision to assist the student in clearing his doubts, like whichever topic is exactly his weak in, we'll be able to identify and capture and thus, you know, help him in what he has done. And many more trends will be put to good use in the coming days. Already Maharashtra has started a homeschooling board, and this only offers more flexibility for the parents and students to explore more of these technologies. Well, EduWatch is itself a separate platform which makes use of all the latest technology to help students to access quality education and teachers to excel at their content delivery. Innovations here are largely frugal by nature, right from the development of content to the tech deployed for distribution. And we were also one of the first companies in India to use machine learning, which has enabled us to pinpoint the pain area of every student and accordingly suggest him or her solutions for his problem. And even the duration of every video content that we have is tailor-made to the average attention span of the kids in that particular age. So EduWatch is majorly focused on the underserved KG to 12th students' problems. If you see, about 91% of Indian schools are ill-equipped, according to the UNICEF report. And they certainly are not capable to handle most of the demands of the modern education ecosystem. And a largely majority of them are located in rural and semi-rural areas. So what we focus on is building a solution and service that can solve this one major problem, which is also affordable to all the students and can substitute the students going to the schools and, of course, extra tuitions. Therefore, this is the place where we are heavily deploying our resources to every reach out, to every village, taluk, and to promote this affordable and quality education. Thus, you know, students and parents from tier 3, 4, 5 towns become our primary audience. Such a program will offer learning to the kids subconsciously, that is, the students will be able to do what they like. Like say, for example, play a game or watch a movie, but the learning happens constantly. They must not feel the burden of academics. The learning must be imbibed into their daily activities. It should not be just limited to the 5 or 6 subjects that their role or school prescribes, and must focus on the skills that will help them later in their lives and also make them more employable, which is the most important part of education. The key points of differentiation here that our content is aimed at replacing the screen time of kids with something more productive, and that is one being aligned to their academic curriculum. Most of the market players seem to have a teacher in a video explaining a concept. Now, these are the teachers the students see in their daily classrooms, in schools, as well as the extra tuition. Therefore, there is not much of incentive for the students to sit through such boring lectures once again. This is being rendered ineffective, especially in a home setup where they're not being supervised. Kids inherently watch a lot of cartoons, and their inertia to change is very less when their academic modules are explained to them in a similar way. That is animations, and that's exactly what we do. In fact, parents are the ones who are heavily benefited by our services, especially those families where both of them are working, as they can provide an unsupervised teaching or learning experience to their kids. Plus, the pricing of our products is such that its per day cost is less than a cup of tea or coffee. It is a huge advantage for the parents that they don't have to invest a fortune in their extra tuition and allied activities. So basically, we are doing some real service here to the fellow citizens. where we are completely solving the main problems of these parents at a very, very affordable pricing, which is very important here, because this is a segment we are going after, the villagers, tier 3, 4, 5, the bottom of pyramid segments. And pricing becomes very, very, very crucial. Also, value for money product needs to be done and implemented in a very effective way. Education system in India is based on Macaulay's way of education, which was designed to promote industrial era workers, and it badly needs a revolution. Major problems in the Indian education systems are, you know, there is a serious lack of functional literacy, and literacy always does not equal to knowledge. There is unemployment despite the job vacancies. The education system promotes private tuitions. There is no major government thrust in promoting the right to quality education, and the theoretical knowledge is being forced upon young students. Lastly, the cost of education is too high compared to the disposable income of families, and access to quality education is being concentrated to the wealthy few. So stress should be on knowledge and learning rather than, you know, being obsessed about marks. The only way is to do away with marks and replace them with grades. Another important thing is that the education should be delivered in their own mother tongue, because that's how an individual can learn best. For example, in the Scandinavian countries, China, or even Japan, who have surged to so much mainly because the medium of instruction in which they learn weren't alien to them. Lastly, the education criteria and jobs should be done away with, and skills criteria should be brought in, which should be made mandatory also. And the whole ecosystem should evolve around this one single metric, where, you know, they should be able to be judged on their skills rather than, you know, what theoretical knowledge they have acquired. For example, there is no point in an aspiring data scientist studying about English literature or history or geography. We started our journey in 2017 with a vision to democratize education, and it's been a great 20 months so far. We have about 20 lakh active users on our platform, and so far about 30,000 used customers who have paid for our services, majorly from the bottom of pyramid segment and from villages as well. That is where we are adding about 15 new users, paid users every day. We are bootstrapped so far, and we have built a very sustainable business impacting the students' lives who don't have access to this basic education infrastructure. We envision a nation where every student has access to same quality of education, which is focused on developing skills rather than rote memorization, and possibly a way that quality education can be free and sustainable as well.
For more updates from CXO TV, please like and subscribe to our channel.